Welcome to yet another interview here at Productronica. I'm at the Norton Aspen Tech stand here with Eric Wong, the product manager. How are you doing today, sir?
Doing well, thanks, Seth.
We were talking yesterday, me and my team, about miniaturization still being ongoing, especially driven forward by the consumer electronics industry. And you guys, as a supplier of dispenser equipment, really have to stay on your toes to keep up. So exactly what are you doing to be a front runner?
Glad you bring this up, Des. So for miniaturization, we see a lot going on for us in smaller and smaller packages, smaller and smaller dies, as well as higher density applications, so like wafer level packaging or underfill, or even on PCBAs or other mobile components where components are getting closer together. Yeah. So we have to be able to jet fluids in between these very narrow gaps. And so in order to do so, we've been working on a new jet system. So we're introducing the IntelliJet system here. It's our newest piezo-driven jet. It allows us to go to very small dot sizes, down to 1 nanometer dots, so we can reach in between these really narrow gaps and be able to do high flow rates of fluid using the higher frequency of the piezo drive system for this jet. So we're running originally with a one of our older model jets, the DJ9500, on one of those applications. And we're getting about a half a wafer an hour in a very narrow gap situation. But we're getting about 1-2% yield loss. And so the customer asks us to look at some of our newer innovations as we introduced to them the IntelliJet. And they were able to not only increase their UPH from half a wafer an hour up to 1.5 wafers an hour, but also to reduce their yield loss from 1-2% down to 0.1% by going to a smaller dot size that's enabled by the system.
So it's completely new. Dispenser heads on this unit as well.
Yes, so the system integrates a new vision system as well as a new dispense jet head and some additional capabilities around process controls for these type of applications on the leading edge advanced packaging.
So sounds like a bit of R&D funding has gone into this.
Quite a bit. We've been working on this for quite a number of years now, and part of that has been because as we go to these higher frequencies and we're doing quite a number of dots, piezo jets tend to wear out after about a billion cycles. The piezo stacks start to lose calibration. The design of this jet was such that we are going to reach 2 to 4 times the lifetime of any other jet that's on the market. We've tested up to 2 billion cycles already, and we're still ongoing with a target of 4 billion cycles before the jet has to go through a major service.
All right.
And it takes us about 6 weeks to do every billion cycles, so that's why it's taking us quite a bit of time to bring this to market.
Is it just me, or is this unit actually smaller in its footprint than your previous units?
The overall system platform is smaller, but the it's the same size.
Okay.
But the jet itself is actually much smaller than any of the other jets that we've put to market so far.
Okay.
Part of this is reduction in weight to allow us to move the system at a higher rate of speed and maintain accuracy that's needed for these miniaturization projects as well.
And what is your expectations reception-wise on this unit?
Reception on this unit so far has been very good. With this one customer that we're talking with, we're expecting quite a large amount of orders to be in soon. As well as we're approaching additional customers, they're all very interested in the new capabilities for the smaller dot sizes, as well as the higher frequencies and the longevity of this unit.
Then I wish you the best of luck with the new unit, and hope to speak to you soon again.
Thanks.